Violence against women is a global problem that is experienced at high levels in South Africa. In two communities, women, men and children have joined hands through a unique program to address the issue of violence against women. Their actions have led to the establishment of clearly demarcated violence-free zones where violence against women is no longer tolerated. United by a shared vision, community members have conducted cleanups, signed manifestos of commitment, painted their streets and homes, and erected signs to show their commitment to change. Violence-free zones are the culmination of a multi-year program entitled Prevention in Action. Whenever violence against women occurs, Prevention in Action participants mobilize to address it by engaging with victims and sometimes with perpetrators to resolve abuse and conflict. Links are provided to services and support is given for reporting and prosecuting offenders. The Prevention in Action program was developed by Project Concern International and the KwaZulu-Natal and Western Cape networks on violence against women, who worked with sector partners and community members to facilitate a community-level response to the challenge of violence against women. At the outset of the program in 2009, research showed that most people rejected attitudes and values that supported violence against women. It was clear that the gap lay in the fact that people were unsure how to respond to violence against women, and this lack of action allowed the problem to continue. Program implementers, together with community members, worked collaboratively to develop a logo, slogan, and communication concepts to convey the idea that it was important to take action in response to violence against women. It was understood that if appropriate actions were taken in sufficient numbers at community level, a tipping point would be reached where violence against women was no longer tolerated and was continuously addressed whenever it occurred. To promote this vision, the program partnered with non-governmental organizations, faith-based organizations, government departments, and police services. Through these partners, groups of community engagers, or CEs, were trained and tasked with identifying and recruiting influential community members to lead the response. This group of volunteers, called community influencers, or CIs, developed strategies for taking action to respond to violence against women, mobilized their friends and family members into prevention action groups, and showed that action to prevent violence against women is possible. Activities were supported by mobilization toolkits that included stickers, posters, badges, and other items which allowed participants to share the idea of prevention in action throughout the community. As the initiative grew, stories of action taken to prevent violence against women were recorded and shared through DVDs and on social media such as Facebook and YouTube. Mobile phone messages were used to encourage participants to continue their actions and to share successes. Participants were also recognized for their leadership through storytelling events and in the news media. Within a period of 18 months, hundreds of CEs and thousands of CIs had been trained and thousands of actions had been taken. To strengthen the response, the CEs and CIs brought together community stakeholders, organizations, and local service providers to form prevention and action committees. Tasked with sustaining this response to preventing violence against women, these committees identified violence-free zones and drew community members into a new vision for a future where violence was no longer accepted. In these areas, public spaces and homes are now demarcated with the colors and logo of the Prevention in Action movement, and pledges have been made to remain vigilant and take responsibility to address violence against women. Experiences of the Prevention in Action program have shown that a shared vision can be developed through partnership, and that new ways of thinking and acting can take hold in communities where there are pressing challenges such as violence against women. Through sharing ideas of how to symbolize prevention of violence against women and clearly demonstrating that action is possible, a new language has emerged to describe solutions to the problem of violence against women. This vision provides an opportunity for a new movement to prevent violence against women. Prevention in Action.